Welcome back to Breslov Campus, about the great efforts that people in history put towards traveling to and seeing tzaddikim as being a big thing. Rebbe Nachman, when he came back from Eretz Yisrael, the Holy Land, he was in his early 20s, and he arrived next to a village called Kaneblad, which is not far from another village called Terhovitza. And in Terhovitza was one of Rabbi Nachman's leading disciples. This man, Rav Yekutiel Landau, the Maggid of Terhovitza, who by that time, when Rabbi Nachman came back from the Holy Land, was approximately 75 years old, at least. And he himself was a Rebbe of no less than 84 villages. And he totally bent himself to be a disciple of Rabbi Nachman. Something phenomenal. A man who himself is of a high stature, a Rebbe, 84 villages, he bent himself to receive from this young Rabbi Nachman, who was in his early 20s. For that, he went through tremendous opposition by his followers and supporters. Who are you to bend to such a young man? But he saw Rabbi Nachman's greatness. And he said, once, you can hide yourself from everybody else, but you can't hide yourself from me. And he was able to see and be aware and recognize and submit and commit himself to Rabbi Nachman's teachings and his greatness. So when this Maggid of Terhovitza, he was known as the Maggid of Terhovitza, Rav Yekutiel, heard that Rabbi Nachman just came back from Eretz Yisrael. How did he hear, by the way? That when Rabbi Nachman was passing by Kaneblad, Rabbi Nachman saw one of the followers of Rabbi Yekutiel, who also became a follower of Rabbi Nachman, and the follower got so excited. So Rabbi Nachman told him, go tell Rabbi Yekutiel that I'm passing by and I'll be staying overnight in Kaneblad, because he didn't want a detour to go into Terhovitza. So the man went running and running to tell the Maggid. And Rabbi Yekutiel at that moment, when his disciple, his follower, told him that Rabbi Nachman has come back from the Holy Land, and at the time he was without his hat, he was wearing just a regular skull cap, a kippah, but he didn't have his respectful normal hat, which you would dress when greeting someone of great stature, and also he wasn't wearing his belt, he was just wearing his jacket but open, and at the time it was more appropriate to walk around greeting someone great that the belt should be closing the overgarment. So he was without his overhead, his hat, and he was without his belt. As soon as the disciple told him that Rabbi Nachman has arrived, he said to him, quick, harness, prepare my horse and wagon, and start coming after me. I'm going to start running ahead to catch up, and you catch up to try to get to me so you can help me speed up. He went so fast, and don't forget, he was over 75 years old. He started literally walking approximately 4.5 kilometers. 4.5 kilometers, over 75 years old, running and running, and he even made it to Rabbi Nachman before his wagon and horse were prepared, and made it. He came before even the wagon, and he traveled so fast in order to greet Rabbi Nachman on his way back from Eretz Yisrael. And Rav Nosson writes, I recorded this story to show you, to show the reader, what a yearning and desire God-fearing people had in order to see the face of a tzaddik, and to teach us that it is no small matter. May we also have the merit to have this awareness and appreciation and recognition of tzaddikim, of the face of tzaddikim, and have a yearning to connect and to greet them and to see them and to join.